السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا، واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا، وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها، كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات لعلكم تهتدون. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. My dear respected brothers, sisters, and elders in Islam, first and foremost, we give thanks to Allah Azza wa Jal, whom from His infinite mercy has granted you and I the ability to spend a part of the day of Jumu'ah in His remembrance. We are answering the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has given us the tawfiq to not only answer the call and also be present, but also learn something for ourselves so that we may deliver it to mankind. That is the purpose with which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given an-nubuwa, the prophethood. He was taught that go and teach the people. بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. That was the command that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Go and preach and tell the people about what Allah has given to you. Go and share the news that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to you. What news is this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He explains, Alif Lam Mim, the huruf muqatta'at. We don't know the meaning. It is a message between Allah and His Rasul. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He continues and says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِي هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. What is the message that Allah wanted to send? What is the entirety of this message? What is the purpose? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining that before I get to the purpose of this book, let me tell you why you can have faith in this book. Let me explain to you why this kitab is the know-it-all, have-it-all. You don't need anything besides this. You have this one book that will give you the definition of the entire universe. You have this one book that will give you the meaning of life in this world. It gives a human being the purpose with which they can live their life. And this is the kitab that will describe this human being's akhirah. So what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give introduction to? He gives introduction to the Qur'an. He says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ. That Qur'an that you are listening to right now, that Qur'an that you are reciting right now, that Qur'an whose message you have heard, لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. There is no shak, there is no doubt, there is no crookedness within this Qur'an. It is a perfect book without any form of change, any form of deviation, any additions or subtractions. This is the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to insan through the lips of Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the kitab for? What is this Quran for? هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It is for the guidance of mankind. My dear brothers and elders in Islam, today let us look at our condition. Let us compare our lives and ask for all of the human beings, not just the Muslims, which country in the world today has hidayah? Which country in the world today has guidance? Which country in the world, which people in the world today can say that we are rightly guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and our guidance is the Quran, and our way of life is the Sunnah, and the mode of living is the living of the Sahaba? Which country, which community, which people can make such a claim? Not a single country in the world can make this claim. And that is why, and that is the answer for why, when we look on the earth today, there is no peace anywhere on the earth. There is no peace. There is no aman. There is no tranquility. Back at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there would be non-Muslims that would enter Medina. They would come into the city of Medina at the time of Salah. At the time of Salah, there would be non-Muslims that would be come into the town of Medina. They would see that the shops that are full of jewelry, the shops that are full of all of these belongings and things that are very valuable, they are left unattended. No one is going and locking up their shops. There is no ADT to go and protect their mal. They don't have a security system or an alarm. They don't have anything. What do they have? They have the tawakkul, that when I go and face in front of my Allah, when I put myself down and I put my face to the ground in submission to my Rabb, Allah is the one that has given to me everything I have in this dunya. Allah is the one that will protect it. How many of us have this type of iman? How many of us have this type of tawakkul? My dear brothers and elders in Islam, today we have faith. We have iman in the Wall Street Journal. We have iman in what is happening on Wall Street itself, the stock exchange, of how it's going up and down. We listen to all of these people that have so much money, and they write books and say, this is how you can become a millionaire. This is how you can become very successful. This is how I turned my $30 into $3 million. And what do? We sign up to get their books. We study their books. We recite and read until we memorize their books and we start practicing upon it. But my dear brothers and elders in Islam, how many of us have done that with the Quran? The book that is what? La rayba fi. There is no doubt within that kitab. There is no mistakes within this book. The writer of this Quran is none other than the Khaliq of everything. He's the creator of everything. That is the one that has sent this Quran. That is the source through which the Quran has come. My dear brothers and elders in Islam, today we look at the Muslim Ummah all over the world. Everyone is in fighting with one another. Everyone is denouncing one another. Everyone is rejecting one another. Yet what does the Quran tell us? I recited the ayah in Surah Ali Imran. In the fourth juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. O those of you that have iman. How many of us have iman? How many of us have iman? Alhamdulillah, we are here because Allah has given to us the ability to attain iman. Allah has given to us the ability to attain iman. We can't say we have iman. You know why? In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala references a situation with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when a group of Bedouins, they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they exclaimed that we believe. We have iman. We have iman. What does Allah say? Allah is narrating that story. He says, قَالَتِ الْأَعْرَابُ آمَنَّا. The Bedouins that came to the Prophet ﷺ, they said, آمَنَّا, we believe. We believe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O Muhammad ﷺ, tell them that they do not have iman just yet. They have aslamna, they have accepted Islam, they have become Muslim. They have merely become Muslim. They have not attained iman. They have not attained taqwa. What is iman, my dear brothers? Today, iman is whenever we see our bank balances go up. Huh? Whenever our bank balances are going up, iman goes up, tawakkul in Allah goes up. Whenever our bank balances go down, iman goes down, tawakkul goes down. Subhanallah. Huh? That is the sad nature. That is the sad condition. Our iman is tied to everything in this dunya. Look at your own condition. For those of the brothers that are having family problems, when Allah fixes your family situation, how many of us go back and make dua and pray salah and give sadaqah like we did during the problems? When it is good times, we don't make any ibadah. When it is times where Allah is giving to us so much wealth, so much blessing, so much peace, there is no ibadah. There is no sacrifice. There is no a'mal that goes along with it. But the moment something goes wrong, but the moment we have some difficulty, the moment something is not working in our favor, immediately we go and we pray 2 rakats. We do this, we do this. My dear brothers and elders in Islam, is that the sign of a Muslim? Is that the sign of a person who has yaqeen that Allah is the one that is giving to him every drop of rizq that he has in this dunya? Is that the sign? What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want from us? Allah is saying, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. This is one of the various different ones that Allah has placed throughout the Quran. This is not the only one. We know that Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu is very famous. And the ulama ikram and the sahaba, especially Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala an, he stated that whenever you hear Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu in the Quran, be very careful and pay very close attention to what comes after it. Because either Allah is giving to you a command, or Allah is prohibiting something from you, or Allah is giving to you an advice which will save you from the fire of Jahannam. So now what does Allah say? Allah is saying, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O those of you that have iman, ittaqullah, fear Allah. This is a command. Ittaqullah, fear your Allah. There is no point in fearing poverty. There is no point in fearing hunger. There is no point in fearing losing your lives. The thing and the one that you should be fearing is Allah alone. If your fear for hunger is over the fear of Allah, if your fear of losing wealth is higher than the fear of Allah, if the fear of losing your life is higher than the fear of Allah, then you are not a true believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and elders in Islam, Allah's command is Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. If you believe and you are trying your best to attain iman and become of those that have iman and will enter with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam into al-jannah, ittaqullah, fear Allah. Fear Allah. That is a very generic statement now. That is a very generic statement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarifies. He says, haqqatu qati. You fear Allah as Allah deserves to be feared. As Allah deserves to be feared. The ulama, they have explained that this fear can also be translated into revered. How you revere someone. How much of a honor and dignity you hold someone up with. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, fear Allah and have reverence for who Allah is in your life. Recognize who Allah is. Recognize where you have come and with whose help you have come therewith. You have to understand that everything and every good that has happened in my life has come from who? Allah. Every good has come from Allah. Everything that I have attained, whether it is my degree, whether it is my schooling, whether it is my spouse, whether it is my job, it is my business, every single thing that you have been given has been given to you and I by who? Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا. Sit there, O insan. Sit in your spot right now and start counting how many things Allah has done for you. لَا تُحْسُوهَا. You will never be able to finish. You will never be able to complete. Your life will run out, but you will not be able to finish how many things Allah has done for you. You will not be able to finish writing that list. But what does Allah say? Innal insan, verily humanity, verily human beings, la zalumun kafar. They're very unjust. They're very unjust and they're ungrateful. The word kafir in this sentence is not referencing unbelievers. It is referencing being ungrateful. So human beings are very unjust when something happens for themselves. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانِ إِذَا مَبَتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَمَى فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا. When Allah is giving to humanity, when Allah is giving to you and I, When Allah has blessed you and I with something, what do we say to Allah? We say, Akraman. Oh, Allah has honored me. Ulama explained, this is with the type of mentality that, you know, I deserve to be honored and Allah has given it to me. I know I deserve it. I worked hard for this. I know I get it. I know I should be getting it. Then what does Allah explain in the same surah? وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبَتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا. On the flip side, when Allah wants to test you, when Allah takes that same human being that used to say that I have gotten here because of what I have done. I have gotten here because of what I have done. It is because I'm a smart person. It's because I'm handsome. I'm physically capable. I'm spiritually able. I'm all of these beautiful things. He's praising himself. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the situation difficult for such a person, what do they say? Rabbi ahanan. It's not me. Allah is the one that's looking down at me. Oh Allah, how could you do this to me? How many of us have ever thought like this? Oh Allah, how could you do this to me? Oh Allah, I pray so much salah, how could you put me in this situation? Subhanallah. 2 seconds ago, when everything was going well, you were praising yourself. Now when things are not going well, you should be telling yourself that it is because of my own faults that this has happened. Yet we blame Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Allah says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. Count the blessings of Allah. You will never be able to finish that count. But verily, human beings are unjust and they are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and elders in Islam, that is just the first ayah that I recited within the beginning of the talk. The main part of the talk was supposed to be the next ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving to us a solution. Giving to us a solution. Today, we have the G8 summit. We have the United Nations. We have the United Arab Nations. We have the United Indian and Indian subcontinent nations. We have all of the United countries in the world looking for a solution to the problems of this world today. They are looking for a way for us to be able to make peace with the world so that human beings can respect the lives of one another, so that we can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and spread the awareness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Khaliq. But nobody in the world is able to come up with the solution. Allah is giving to us the solution in the Quran. What does Allah say? وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Come together. Come together. Unify yourselves. بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. Through the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through the strong grasp that Allah has given to you. What is this strong grasp? What is this rope of Allah? It is Kitabullah, the book of Allah, this Quran. Allah is telling you and I, you want the solution to your problems? وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Come together and hold on to the Quran, to the book of Allah. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And do not allow that your skin make a differentiation between you. Do not allow that your tongue and the languages that come from your tongue make a differentiation between amongst you. Do not allow that the wealth of this world split you apart, or the preferabilities of one group to another split you apart. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. Come together and hold on to the book of Allah. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Do not let anything come between you and another Muslim that is with you. Come together and follow the Quran. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Don't let anything differentiate. وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And praise Allah for all of the things that He has done. Praise Allah for all the good that He has given to you and I. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues. I don't have enough time. Although this is the Thanksgiving weekend. This is Thanksgiving weekend. Many of us have, mashallah, turkeys in our bellies from last night. Huh? So we should be good to go for the next couple of hours, right? Yes? Alhamdulillah. For those of the brothers that are a little skeptical, we're not going to continue. But that in itself is a reminder. We give how much time? How much time are we giving to the remembrance of Allah on a weekly basis? How much time are we spending in the masjid? How much time are we spending in the dhikr of Allah? How much time are we spending reading the Quran? How can we say that we are holding on to the Quran when the last time we read Quran or we heard Quran was in Ramadan? How can we say that the Quran is our friend or that we recite the Quran when the only surahs that we are reading in our salah is Inna Atayna Kalkawthar and Wal Asr? Although that is not to take away anything from those two surahs, they are very beautiful and mighty surahs. But we don't do it, we don't read these surahs for their original purpose. We read them to shorten our salah and mashallah. Huh? When are we going to get real with ourselves? When are we going to start getting honest? How many people, they used to pray right next to us, pray in the same masjid, in the same spot that we're sitting in right now. They used to pray with us. They're no longer in this dunya. We buried them with our own hands. Our own relatives, we buried them with our own hands. We put them into the qabr by our own selves. We saw them, we were witnesses. If that has not shaken our hearts, if that has not changed our lives, if that has not reminded us, my dear brothers and elders in Islam, what will remind us of Akhirah? What will remind us of the fact, not a future prediction, a fact that every single person sitting in this room will die. Every single person sitting in this room will pass away. There is a time appropriated for each and every one of us. There is a time that is given. Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. Every creature of Allah will die. My dear brothers and elders in Islam, today we run after everything because we don't see ourselves dying. Ask yourselves, what are the plans for the rest of my life? For those students that are going to college, you would say, I'm going to finish college, I'm going to start a nice job, get married to a beautiful sister, have many children inshallah ta'ala, have a nice business thereafter, have a nice house, have a car. What's after that? I'm going to retire. What's after that? They're not going to say anything. Because we know that every list, no matter who is being asked, every list will end with what? I will die. Every person's list, no matter what your goals are in this dunya, every single person's list will end with the fact that we are going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how many of us want to return with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being pleased with us? How many of us? Every one of us want this. But we need to make sure that we are doing the right work. We need to make sure that we are following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We need to make sure that we are the examples of Muslims. Today we have so many people running around doing this sin and that sin and this sin and that sin, and the moment something happens regarding someone drawing a picture of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they get so upset all over the world. We have Muslims that are burning places down, burning homes down, burning businesses down because someone who is crazy drew a picture of the Prophet ﷺ. Yet the same Muslims, we are not following the sunnah. We are not following the sunnah of Muhammad ﷺ. We are indulged in sins. What would hurt the Prophet ﷺ more? What would hurt him more that a bunch of people who don't know who he was, non-Muslims, are making pictures of him? Or that Muslims who believe in Islam and in the Quran are not following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What would hurt him more? What would be of more dard to him? My dear brothers and elders in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, and I will end with this inshallah, because we already know what we need to do. This Quran is telling us, اتَّقُوا اللَّهُ Fear Allah. حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Fear Allah as He deserves to be feared, and do not die except that you are a Muslim. And number two, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا Make sure that you are reading the Quran on a daily basis. Make sure you are reading the tafsir of the Quran on a daily basis. Learn one ayah every day. How many? One ayah a day. Is that difficult? And I'm not telling you to memorize. Read one ayah from the Quran, understand what the translation is, and if we don't know what it actually means, go and ask an imam. Go and ask a scholar and say, Ya Sheikh, I read this one ayah today. Can you explain to me what this means? Can you explain to me what this means? Make it consistent. أحب الأعمال إلى الله أدومها وإن قلّا. That the best of the deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves are those deeds that are done. They're very small, but they're very consistent. Don't read, you know, the entire Quran one night and don't touch it for another year. There's no benefit in it. Read a juz of Quran every day. Read a page of Quran every day. Read a surah from the Quran every day. But make sure it is consistent. Make sure that you are spending time in the ibadah of Allah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to be proper Muslims. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant peace and aman to all the human beings on this earth. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect the lives of all of the innocent people, whether they are Muslim, whether they are non-Muslim. We ask Allah that, Ya Allah, you protect the lives of the innocent. Oh Allah, you remove the zalimeen and the oppressors from this earth. Oh Allah, we ask of you to guide mankind to the real meaning of the Quran and Sunnah. Oh Allah, we ask of you to enable us as Muslims to follow the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Oh Allah, we ask of you to enable us to be beacons of hidayah for mankind. Enable us to take the message of the Quran to mankind. Oh Allah, we ask of you to portray the best of the messages from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is being kind and courteous to everyone, which is being very respectful to everyone, which is preaching and teaching peace to every single person and enabling people to know and to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one God, the only God, is the one that has created all of mankind and we are going back to Him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to live and to die with the kalima on our tongue, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ma alayna illa al-balagh. Few minutes for sunnah inshaAllah.